Hello everyone, my name is Sydney Moore. I'm a master's student here at the University of Missouri in the Department of Plant Sciences and Technology. I'm a student under Andy Thomas working in American elderberry. So I am doing a genotype by environment study in American elderberry. And you can kind of see that out here. This is one of my locations here at the Horticulture and Agroforestry Research Farm. I have 5 site locations spanning from Wisconsin down to Oklahoma, so also in Illinois and Missouri, so I have 4 states in there. And then I also have 12 varieties of American elderberry from about 8 different states that we've planted at each of those locations. So we're seeing how the different genotypes from the different locations throughout the Midwest and kind of down to Florida, up to Minnesota, how they react in these different kind of varying environments. Oklahoma and Wisconsin are 2 very different places, so we're kind of seeing how they act in the extremes as well as in those middle areas. So there's genotype and phenotype. Genotype is what we have in our genes, while phenotype is the physical expression of those genes. So when I say genotype, that's the different cultivars or cultivated varieties that we grow. So we have, like I said, different cultivars from different states that we are looking at. So they just have different genes from being adapted in different locations. So what we have found so far in the different locations is, first off, we have very different flowering happening, different phenology of the plants. You can kind of see out across the field, the plant that is still flowering is our Florida variety. So there's quite a bit of difference between fruits from Missouri that have fully set fruit, and I'm planning on harvesting most of them today. Well, like I said, Hamilton, which is from Florida, is fully flowering and now actively setting berries, which is nowhere near harvest. As well, at the different sites, we have different pressures. So in Oklahoma, we have an aerified mite issue. So that's something that we're actively dealing with. We're seeing quite a bit of difference between the cultivars at that site as well. Some plants are showing some resistance while others are just completely decimated by the mites. And then in Wisconsin, we have some Japanese beetles issue as well. Well, again, some are completely decimated, others are completely fine and untouched. So we're seeing some pretty serious differences just between cultivars at the same site and as well cultivars at the different sites that are the same cultivar. Here I have a Minnesota variety that I have a really hard time getting to be established. It doesn't want to seem to live well at the Southwest Center, so even just here within Missouri, it is thriving down there and doing great. So they love to be completely different, even though it's the exact same thing sometimes. So this is our second year of the study. Last year they were planted, so they were 1 year old, so we did not get any fruit off of them. We pinched any flowers that they produced off so that they directed to more root growth. And then this year we're letting them fully fruit. It will be more of a smaller harvest than other years because it is their first year fruiting, so they are still pretty young. But next year we hope to have a full harvest, and the study will continue on after I graduate. But for my part of the study, we will go until December of 2024, so we have 2 full years of fruiting data. So like I said, guys, we're actively working on this project and collecting data for it. We hope you guys will check back next year. We're hoping to do a follow-up. But also, if you have any questions about our project or any of the other projects going on in American elderberry, you can check out elderberry.missouri.edu. That is our project website where we will be posting all the updates that we get.